皆様こんにちは。
Hello, everyone. So from here, we'd like to begin the round table for the motorbikes. Thank you very much for joining us. I'll be the MC.
司会を務めさせていただきます。ヤマハ発動機の
From Yamaha Motors, my name is Kurabe.
では、今日の登壇者をまずご紹介
をさせていただきます。Presenters today.
Kawasaki Motors, 株式会社。
From Kawasaki Motors, President and CEO, Mr. Hiroshi Ito.
Yamaha 発動機社長。
And from Yamaha Motor Company Limited, President CEO, Yoshihiro Hidaka. Suzuki Motor Corporation Managing Director, Mr. Masayoshi Ito.
今日はこの3名の方にご登壇いただきます。まず改めまして、日高から二輪車メーカーとしてのカーボンニュートラルの取り組みを簡単にご紹介させていただきまして、皆様から質疑応答をしたいと思っております。And after that,
we would like to receive questions from the floor. 日高さん、please.
私、共同記者会見の方で、
So in the joint conference, I've made some comments, and I think all the members in this room is the same. So I think I should skip my part, and rather,Since we have Ito-san from Kawasaki, also Ito-san from Suzuki, so a little bit complicating. So I won't call on saying their family names, but call on their company names. So can we start with Kawasaki Motor, please? I'm from Kawasaki Motors. I'm Ito. Earlier, our president of Kawasaki Heavy Industries, Hashimoto, has explained a lot of things happening in our company, so I don't have much else to say. But for Kawasaki,Kawasaki Motors, we are the motorbike business area, and I think I can introduce a little bit of what we do. So on the 6th of October, we had our business policy explanation briefing, and as I said there, until 2035, our main products, electrification, battery EVs, and also the hybrid EVs, we're going to work both on that. And then by 2050, we will be introducing more than 10 electrified vehicles. So that is the plan that we have. And of course, for carbon neutrality, we'll have to prepare, we want to prepare the lineup of a wide variety of technologies. That's the vision that we have. So this time, hydrogen engine, this is also very important for us in a sense that the internal combustion engines can continue. It will be significant in that sense. So we'd like to continue to work in this direction too. Thank you.
I'm
Ito, also from Suzuki Motor Corporation.
先ほど日高社長の方がいろいろと
As President Hidaka explained earlier in the conference, I don't have so much to add. But when we talk about carbon neutrality, what is happening in the motorbikes world is the question that I receive a lot. And my response will be, well, we want to look into a variety of paths, not just EVs. And when we do that, commuters, the 125cc, the 50cc, those smaller type of vehicles, we are now working on the exchanging swap, battery swapping system type of trial.Demonstrations together with the four-wheelers, and that's going fine. But for the larger type of vehicles, the users want to enjoy driving the large motorbikes. And when we electrify the large motorbikes, what happens is that the batteries will become heavier, larger, the cruising range will be shorter, and the joy of biking, riding motorbikes, is going to be lessened. And therefore, with ourselves from the technology side, we have been discussing to find any other optionsthat we can pursue. Then we have started to come up with the conclusion of looking into hydrogen engine. And this was a timing where President Hidaka approached us. And we were saying that if the joy to ride the large motorbikes is gone, then the consumers are not going to buy the products. And of course, hydrogen engine, there's a lot of technical challenges. But we want to pursue a way so that the customers can continue to enjoy driving the large motorbikes. And so that is why why we decided to work together on hydrogen engine development very quickly. So, and that is why we have agreed to join this effort. And also, there's areas of collaboration, but also competition. So we want to differentiate those two areas. And that is will be our approach. Thank you. Thank you from Kawasaki Motors and Suzuki Motor Corporation as well. So now to receive questions from the floor. In the table in front, we also could not receive the questions of who are participating online. So can we first receive questions from the media participating online, and then we would like to receive questions from those in this room. Thank you for your understanding and cooperation. So the media who is participating online, if you have a question, please press your raise hand button to show that you would like to ask a question. And when you ask your question, please introduce your name and affiliate, and then go on with your question, please. Thank you.
From Chunichi Newspapers,
Nakahira-san. Nakahira-san, please, from Chunichi Newspapers.
I'm
Nakahira from Chunichi Newspapers. Can you hear me? Yes, we hear you. Thank you. Since this is a different topic roundtable, I'd like to once again ask President Hidaka. So this time, you're talking about the joint development consideration and looking into the possibility with the motorbikes company. So for the electrification of motorbikes, I do see some companies are doing actual considerations. And first of all, my question would be the significance of looking into this possibility of hydrogen engines. And one more question is that you said that there are going to be a fine line between collaboration and competition. So right at this point of time, the areas, how are you thinking of dividing this area of collaboration and competition? Those will be my two questions. Thank you. So first of all, for electrification and the ICEs, the balance of these two types of technology, I think that the energy density of batteries currently, and also for the cruising range with full charge of the batteries, and also the space in the motorbikes, it is quite limited. So from the balance of these elements, I think that the current small vehicle 50cc or 125cc scooter area, small size motorbikes, these types of products probably will be accepted more with the EV type of products. So that is the way that we are thinking, and we have the two-wheelers battery consortium initiatives. And however, for the 125cc or more, like up to 250 and 400 and 1,000, the more that you go into the larger size motorbikes, the space to mount the batteries, and also if we say hypothetically that we try to create by force a space to have a battery and create a battery EV motorbike, it's going to become more heavier and you're going to need more energy. And if we try to see the cruising range, it will be quite limited. Then the larger bike consumers are going to be asking questions, why are we riding this motorbike? What is the fun of driving? So that from that sense, we thought that it would be very difficult to have fully electrified those large size motorbikes. And earlier, as Suzuki said, for the big bikes, the ICEs and the engine types, engines will have possibilities. So that was the idea that we had from before. So for two-wheelers, we're not denying batteries. And also, there are areas where the batteries will be more suitable, appropriate, and where customers want the batteries, that's fine. But if there there's other areas that is probably more fit for the ICEs and the engines, we want to pursue that a little further. So that's why with Kawasaki, Suzuki, and Honda, we approached them and decided to work together.
And one more point about collaboration and competition. Kawasaki, Suzuki, Honda, we were all rivals. And in the scene of racing, of course, we were competing against each other. ICE engine itself is the field of competition, I believe. However, from the user side, we do need people. We need more friends to be on the user side, or else R&D won't develop. So one thing is the hydrogen tank. Kawasaki has already been working on various measures and methods. I believe that Kawasaki has accumulated know-how. And one more point is the engine. How are we going to put in the fuel, the hydrogen into the tank, and so that type of piping, and also the final emission too? If we do need a certain volume in order to realize, or else then it is difficult to gain support from the component makers. That is why I think we can't do it just by Yamaha, and with Kawasaki together, two companies won't be enough. That is why we need Suzuki and Honda to work with us, and that is why we decided to talk with them, and we have received answers in a forward-looking way. Then, Japanese manufactured four companies altogether, I think that the component manufacturers will also be forward-looking in supporting us. I think that is why this field will be the area we can jointly collaborate. But going forward, I think four companies, engineers, discussing which fields should be collaborated and which fields should remain for competition. I think that is the starting point of our discussion, which is going to happen going forward. Thank you very much. Next question, please.
Shizuoka Shimbun, Yamamoto-san, please.
Yamamoto
from Shizuoka Shimbun speaking.
よろしくお願いいたします。お声聞こえております。
Yes, thank you. We hear you well.
まず近くこの4社で
Four companies. Are you going to establish a kind of consortium? That is my first question. And also, the specific verification items, where are you going to start? What are you going to start? What is your priority?
以上です。
That's all.
はい、先ほどもちょっとお話ししたように、
yes.
まだ
I did touch on it already, but we are still at a stage.
川崎さんとヤマハとはですね、
ヤマハ and 川崎。
今回トヨタさんにGo Between をしてもらっていろいろ話してたんですけども、まあ鈴木さん、小田さんには
came between us and now we decided that we can work together. And however, I think the remaining two companies, Suzuki and Honda, we have just called on them to work together. That is why the details are yet to be decided. However, Yamaha and Toyota Kawasaki, what we have been discussing until today, that will be the draft, and Honda Suzuki will join us.
話し始めるところからこれからやるという段階です。
The discussion. That is where we are at now. The specific element technology where we should be starting, I cannot share with you. So the technology side, we would like to come back to you from our external affairs, our PR division. Thank you.
はい、ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much. 日刊自動車新聞水鳥さん、please.
すみません、日刊自動車新聞社の水鳥です。Yes,
水鳥 from 日刊自動車新聞。Yes.
はい、お願いします。すみません、ちょっと先ほどの質問とも被るんですけれども。
It overlaps with the previous question, but the joint research to work on that, Yamaha, Kawasaki, and other companies, which division will the members be allocated, and also how many members for that joint research? When will you be deciding? What is the timeline to make that actual decision for joint research? And the other question is for Ito-san of Suzuki. In the roundtable, President Hidaka said, talked about the difficulty of fuel cell two wheels, but Ito-san, I think you tried the two-wheel batteries, and also I think that you do have your experience in the fuel cells motorbike, and you know the difficulties. What do you say? Regarding the first question, I will answer. Each company, hydrogen engine, the engineers. First of all, I think it is important that engineers start the discussion. So Kawasaki, Suzuki, Honda, and us, Yamaha, our technology in our company, Maruyama-san's the director of technology, and for automobile working with Toyota, head of technology is Komatsu-san. So I think Maruyama-san or Komatsu-san will be involved in the discussion, the first discussion. And I think that the members at the same level will be joining four companies to decide about what to do for the future. I think that will be the starting point. Yes, Ito of Suzuki, the Bergman, FC Bergman, what we've been working on, I would like to explain. Sorry, I'm not an engineer, so I can't talk about the details, but the difficulty of fuel cells, the cost, and the cruising distance is very short. That is why we are still unable to commercialize it. Because it is hydrogen, the tank is large. It is difficult to put it on the motorcycle, and it is costly. That is why it is still difficult to commercialize. That is why, going forward, if we can jointly work on it, we can bring the cost down. With that, I hope that we will be able to launch something affordable. FC Bergman, we are still continuously working on it, but it is still far from launching it in the market. That's all. Thank you.
Next question, Young Machine, Matsuda-san, please.
Young Machine 編集部の松田と申し
ますけれども、I'm Matsuda from Young Machine. Can you hear me? Yes.
はい、よろしくお願いいたします。
Thank you.
まず最初に、とても胸熱な会見でした。
It was a very, it was a press conference full of passion.
ライダーをこうワクワクさせる、そういう決断を下してく
れた。And I think, my understanding was that you've made a determination that is a full, that will excite the riders. On behalf of all riders, I'd like to express my appreciation. Now my question. Yamaha, Kawasaki, you're looking into the possibilities of technologies related to hydrogen engine.And including fuel cells, I think that's you're going to look into the opportunities. And Honda, Suzuki, you said that they have a forward-looking response now, but right now you're not the four company consideration.Yet, well, basically, we have made an agreement between the four companies. You can understand it in that way. And we have Ito-san from Suzuki coming here to join us because of that agreement. Actually, from around September, suddenly we started to talk about this idea. And we didn't have so much time since then with Suzuki, Honda. I did went to visit Suzuki to make the request, and it was just few weeks ago that I actually visited them. So we kind of forcibly received the agreement from Suzuki and also met with Ito-san too. And also Honda, we've met in a semi-timing just a few weeks ago. So we still didn't have time to make good adjustments between each other. So basically, it will be the same agreement between Yamaha and Kawasaki that will be agreed, that has been agreed with Suzuki and Honda as well. So Honda is not here yet, but it was just a problem of schedule? Yes.
Today, we usually have the JAMA two-wheeler conference. These three men, there's Mr. Abe joining us usually for JAMA two-wheelers group. We asked him to join, but his schedule couldn't be adjusted. So that's why he couldn't come. So that's the only reason why Honda is not here. Understood. Thank you. From here, we'd like to receive questions from the floor in this conference room. If you have any questions, please raise your hand. Are you okay? I'm Katsumata from Chubu Keizai Shimbun. So if the hydrogen engine is commercialized, so that's, I have a question then. For the high output, there are certain characteristics like the high output, and not just contributing to carbon neutrality, using the characteristics of the hydrogen engine, I think it can push up the product appeal for the motorbike. So what is your idea about that? Thank you for your question. Basically, whether we use gasoline or hydrogen, the characteristics of the engine will not change so much. But there's also a lot of things unknown for hydrogen engine at this point. So going forward, as we continue our research, we're going to learn more about the hydrogen characteristics. And when that becomes more clear, we're going to create products that will create excitement and fun utilizing those characteristics of hydrogen. Did we answer your question? Thank you. Then, next person. I'm Tanigawa from Car Watch. Earlier, you said that tank-related technologies will be Kawasaki technologies, and for the tank on the car side, the air compression, 70 mega, is used for the compression. And Kawasaki has a high capability in handling liquefied hydrogen. So for the motorbikes, is it about using liquefied hydrogen? I think I heard that before, or not. But when we think of utilizing hydrogen for two-wheelers, is it going to be, are you going to use the liquefied hydrogen or the gas hydrogen? Thank you. We are using have large size projects like having the liquefied hydrogen tanks on the marine vessels. So whether or not we can utilize that same technology for two-wheelers is something to consider from now. So we haven't set any direction yet for this perspective. Thank you. Anyone else? From Nihon Keizai Shimbun, my name is Fukumoto. So in the announcement made today with Mazda, Subaru, synthetic fuel, biofuel was also a topic that was announced today. This time, for two-wheelers, you've talked about pursuing the hydrogen engine. What about synthetic fuel and biofuel possibilities for two-wheelers? And when you compare with the hydrogen engine, what will be the strengths that you have? So when you compare with those synthetic and biofuels, what will be the strength of hydrogen engines? If I'm wrong, then my Maruyama-san, who's the engineer, can correct me. But if I start, my understanding is that synthetic fuels will, first of all, start from using hydrogen to create synthetic fuel. So you first have to produce the hydrogen in order to make the synthetic fuel. So if it means that you need to do an additional process after producing hydrogen, then the cost for the each unit, then the synthetic fuel will be higher when you think about that. Then when also from the perspective of producing, transporting, and using, our final product manufacturers are going to be the using side, but how to produce and transport, where we can have places to refuel for our tanks and the ICEs need to be prepared to meet those other sides as well. So the carbon neutral fuels, if the situation allows that you can use the stations, the normal stations that we have now in the cities, or if there's going to be the hydrogen stations newly built to refuel these engines, it will change our situation. But when you think about it, you need to have an additional process in order to create the carbon neutral fuels. So even ahead of that, if we can use hydrogen directly, if we can have a hydrogen engine so that we can even use the hydrogen before creating the synthetic fuel, that will be another option. And if I'm wrong, please correct me, but probably the carbon neutral synthetic fuel is compared to hydrogen, it can be adapted easier. So the development hurdle is going to be much lower for synthetic fuels. So that's why if we are capable of handling hydrogen, probably we will be able to handle synthetic fuels easier. So I think it's important that we challenge the more difficult side. So that's my way of thinking.
Any
other question?
すみません、フリーランスの木野と申します。
I'm Kino, freelance journalist.
今後 のタイムスケジュールというか、
I would like to ask about
時間軸の timeline going forward. 先ほどの会見で、まあ、明確には決まっていないというお話があった
一方で、現状it was said nothing specific is decided. However, carbon neutral, the commitment to Paris Agreement, I think there is a deadline which will be driven from that. So, what will be the priority going forward?
方向性というか、
Do you have any direction how to prioritize? If there's anything you can share about the future schedule,
おそらく各社さんごとにその辺というのはお考えが終わりだと思いますので、
I think each company has its own ideas. However, for us, 2050 carbon neutral, to achieve that, we are going to maximize our effort. Member of JAMA have already agreed on that, 2050 towards carbon neutrality. I think that there are multiple paths, however, to achieve this target for sure, we are going to maximize our effort. Which one?Can be commercialized, which technology will be penetrated to the society? Of course, we do see electrification already. However, can electrification solve everything, all the cars globally? And four wheels.Alt and two wheels in Japan altogether, about 80 million units. We already see new challenges, and I think towards 2030 we will see more and more situation. So 2030, two decades until 2050, I think we can still succeed if we decide at that point in time. As Yamaha, I mean, not all the companies, but as Yamaha, that is what we think. We should hold multiple options and decide by 2030. President Hidaka, what he said is what we are also aiming. How we should be setting the milestones, I think there could be various options, but the current stage, I believe it is important we hold multiple options. We are still trying to find out what is optimal. I think that's where we are at. As Suzuki, towards carbon neutrality, I think there are multiple ways. One measure is electrification and synthetic fuels, another hydrogen engine is another.
So,
OEMs, we have wonderful technology of ICE from history. So, when, of course, politically 2030, 2050, we often hear that. So, in order to align with that, in our company, we should be setting the priority and we should head forward in order to achieve that target. Thank you very much. It's very near our closing. One final question from Nikkei newspaper, Yamanaka-san, joining us online, please.
もしもし聞こえますか?
Hello, do you hear me? Yes.
ありがとうございます。日経新聞で記者をしている山中と
言います。I am Yamanaka from Nikkei newspaper. I have two questions. Number one, regarding motorcycles.
バイクもともとガソリンであったり、あと川重さん、
There's gasoline and Kawasaki. You have hybrid. You've tried hybrid and also electrified ones, EVs, and you have hydrogen. And you did talk about biosynthetic fuels, but For the future, motorcycles, each of it, for example, hybrid, EV, hydrogen, synthetic fuel, could it be each fuel a different model or in one model, just changing the components a little bit, you can apply diverse fuels? What is your view about the future?
すいませんお見合いをしてしまいました、
yes. Sorry. We wondered who should speak first, but to be honest, I still don't know. 丸山さん、is there anything you want to say?
ヤマハ発動機で技術系を見ております丸山です。
I am in charge of technology in Yamaha Motor. 丸山さん。
今おっしゃられたようにいろんな努力への選択肢が今増えているというふうに我々も考えておりまして、最終的なカーボンニュートラルを目指すために
、in order to achieve carbon neutral, we are working on development every day.I think each has its unique characteristic as technology. It has its strength and weak points. That is why.To answer your question, in one model, having multiple energy source, or rather, I think how that model is used and what is the benefit to the user. Towards that, I think we should be applying the optimal technology needed. Unfortunately, we need further investigation of technology, or else we cannot say at the moment which fuel is best for whichtype of model, which energy is best. But as President Hidaka said, in several years or in this decade, we have to decide which one we are going to choose, which way we are going to go. Yes, I would like to add one point. Alternative fuel, the supply infrastructure is extremely important, and I think that differs country to country. This region, for example, like Brazil,They have ethanol, so the mainstream might be biofuel. And Japan, I think we are quite advanced in hydrogen, so maybe we should be the forerunners in hydrogen. So there is an issue of infrastructure and also the characteristic of each technology. I think that the conclusion will be made with that combination.
Yes, for bike, there's commuters, sports.そういった中で、例えば日常のですね、移動に使われているマスクだ原付 1cc については、まあ、1日とか走る距離がですね、30キロ、40キロくらいですので、
まあ、こういったものについては、まあ、電動が便利じゃないかと。
これ、私、先ほど申し上げましたが、我々のユーザー、お客様はですね、やはり乗って楽しい。というのは、大きなバイクに、例えばスポーツバイクとかございます。それが、重くて走らないバイクになってしまいますと、まあ、誰にも買っていただけない
They cannot enjoy the driving of the motorcycle. No consumer will choose us. That is why how it is used, depending on how it's used, we should be selecting the fuel and we should be selecting which product should be using which technology. That's our idea. Okay, thank you very much. One final question, please. I was watching the five company conference too. I see, especially toProtect the supplier, that is one important meaning to continue, I see, I thought. But I thought also at the same time towards carbon neutrality in 2050, going towards that at OEM, I think that you have to be making requests to suppliers. For example, from 2020, 2021, if you're going to decrease, for example, I believe it will be like 3% to 5%, you should be decreasing the amount. So to the supplierHow will you be asking that burden and how are you going to improve with the suppliers?
まずですね、カーボンニュートラルをやっていく
when we pursue carbon neutrality, to achieve carbon neutrality, right now, we are focused on the category 3 emissions for products. But going forward, carbon tax and other issues, when it comes out, then we have to look into category 1 and 2 as well. So that will be the process of making the products, how much CO2 is emitted. We need to understand correctly and also to come up with the numbers. And right now, globally, the yardstick that we use to measure, there are some main ones, and there is no global standard for the measurement. So Japan will have its own main way of measuring emissions, and we do use that for the calculations. But going forward, not just the makers, but the companies that cooperate with us in supplying the parts, in their process as well for Category 1 and 2, how much emissions they have for CO2 needs to be measured and understood, and that needs to be reflected into the numbers that we know of for the emission of the products. And in COP26 conference, the European movements like the border tax and carbon adjustment taxes was being discussed. So going forward, in order to be in time, JAMA, also the JAPIA will be the areas that we will have discussion to clarify on what measurements that and yardsticks we'll be using. Then after that, we will enable each company to measure it in a common way. And then based on the calculation with those measurements for Category 1, 2, and 3, we will pursue with our carbon neutrality initiatives. So that is how JAMA and JAPIA is thinking of going forward. And of course, for the four companies here, we have the own suppliers, but some of it of the suppliers are common. And if each company works in a different way, then those suppliers, the cooperating companies, is going to be a lot of burden on them. That also we recognize. Therefore, those areas we need to cooperate. And through JAMA, JAPIA, we're going to work together so that those initiatives can be pursued. First of all, we will understand our own emissions and to visualize that with numbers. And then after that, we'll have to gain knowledge on how to reduce that part. And that sharing of knowledge on how to reduce the CO2 emissions will be important to pursue the actual CO2 reduction. That stage will probably be around 2026, 2027. That would be the last timing to start the reduction. So we need to be in time for that timing.
よろしいでしょうか?
Did that answer your question? Yes, thank you.
ではお時間となりましたので、これで2人のラウンドテーブルを終了させていただきます。
Come to the end of the round table for the motorcycles. And going forward, we're going to continue to work on expanding the circle of this like-minded makers, and we hope to receive the support from the press as well. Thank you very much for attending today.